How's it going, everybody? My name is FOXSOL, and welcome to another video here in Lords of the Fallen. You glorious bastards, you. We have a new quest line that came out for Lords of the Fallen called, basically, the Way of the Bucket. And here's Bucket Bro. Now, I've already activated his quest pretty much. And the way you do this is straight up. You're going to go ahead and you're going to go run through your emotes. This is what's worked for me is I will go over here and I will make sure that we select. Just to give you an idea, we're going to go ahead and we're going to equip every single one of these right here that you have in your inventory. All right. And then you're going to run from the first to the end. You're going to go ahead. You're going to go to your seconds list right here and do the same thing. It doesn't seem like you have to have every emote or anything. You just got to have enough to do this. And then you end it with the bucket salute. Now, I don't know why this works. How this works. Because honestly, to me, this should not work. But this seems to work. Now, it appears that my wireless controller is dead. Let me go ahead and plug that in. Medical difficulties. So, what do you do here? Well, let me go show you. We got to fight mini bosses for a little bit. Won't take long. We got to fight four. There's eight of them that you got to kill. Let's see, can Bucket Bro just do it? Let's get her out the way. Dang, she actually hurting. We'll just use magic. Screw it. Give my two barrage roots on. We're gonna get that. Now with that dead, you're able to collect this. Now, what I recommend in regards, do not collect this. Now, this character is basically a fresh character. So you're going to have to bear with me. We're going to have to run this game pretty fast. And we're going to collect the first four. I'm going to make this a two-part series, okay? Where to collect us all at. So when you're going to watch this video, I'm going to be recording the next video and doing the next four mini bosses. But the idea is that you're going to be collecting this. So we're going to be able to get two of them real quick right here. Three, possibly four real quick. First things first, we need to talk to this guy here. I need to talk to him real quick. You don't have to. I need to because I need to get the key from him. To go ahead and get to a new area, to the bell tower area a little bit faster. So it took me a little while to figure this out. And it's actually pretty cool. And I kind of want to, and you don't have to don no helmet or anything like I thought you originally had to. You don't have to look like Bell Bro. You just need basically the buckets. And you just need to go through with this. So yeah, that's going to be a little bit of an adventure. But hey, if you're new to the game and you don't know the area too well and you want to do this quest line, you get lost pretty easily. This is the route that we're going to take to get there. Yeah, we'll be able to get four bosses here relatively fast. So what you do is that when you collect four bosses, you turn in four buckets. Do not collect more than four at a time. Once you collect five, you fuck the quest up and you have to wait till you go to new game plus whatever or reset new game zero in order to do it. That's pretty much what happens with this quest line. I screwed up two characters already doing that. And I figured it out with the third character. what you needed to do. And then so we basically, which is, this is the third character, and I just reset it in its game and I got us to this area. So, and instead of going opening areas first for you guys and then just doing, you know, a small video, this one's gonna be a little bit longer. And I hope you appreciate it. I hope you'll accept this. So what you should be able to do is with the first four buckets, you should be able to get what's the bucket feet. The next four buckets, you get the bucket head. So far from my understanding. Now, since I'm on New Game Plus One, this makes it a little bit easier because we can just reset the game. But for you people on New Game Zero that don't want to go rush all the way to the Sauna Mardark boss and do all that stuff all over again, this is, just keep in mind, real quick off the top of your head, collect four buckets and four buckets only. Don't collect more than that. You collect more than four buckets, you ruin the quest, and you can't do it again unless you do a whole new game. Now, what's going to be cool here is that I'm hoping, just like in the stream, this is going to happen again, where Bucket Bro is going to actually come out and help us in this fight. It was pretty cool to see that. So basically, this route right here, we're just going to go straight to Bell Bro over here. We're going to fight Bell Bro. After Bell Bro, we're going to make it back to Bell. We're going to go take the long way around. We're going to go fight the Hound Chick. After we fight the Hound Chick, we're going to go straight towards Let's see. I don't know, actually. I'm not sure. I want to say we're going to go to the Gorge. Like, we need to go to Cathlith, but at the same point time, we don't have to go there. I might be wrong. We'll see. Bear with me. Maybe I should have opened the areas. If I got to, I'll edit this video. There he is. And this is what happens. For Bucket Tree! We got a Bucket Bro. Alright, he dead. Actually, you know what? We can make this a little bit quicker. Just a tad bit quicker. Let's go to the castle. That'll make our third. So, yep, I'm using, and by the way, I am using my level 6000 character because this is the character that we use to prove bullet sponging on bosses. So if you've been catching our live streams, this is what's been happening. God damn, stop shooting me in the back, motherfucker. Actually, because this right here, you'll be able to get two of them right here. This will be actually pretty, this is actually be the fastest route, because the other one, you have to go through all the entire thing with the doors and all that other crap. I don't want to do all that. But you go through that area next, you go get your next four bosses done, and then you get your bucket. Do I have, yes I do. We can go ahead and reset real quick if need be. I think we're good. I think we can make this. I think we can make this. Or we keep getting shot in the head and get have some brain damage here. Oop, wrong one. Got my way. Just got my way. So that way I can do this before Red Reaper comes and murders us all. So it took a little while figuring this out. Like I said, I wanted to re-record all this. And I figured, like I said, for someone who's brand new, you'll get the idea of what we're doing. This is, like I said, this is part one of a part two video series that I'm going to put up. But this one right here, if you don't watch the second video, I think you'll get the gist of what's going on. And I think I can run this pretty fast, to be honest. I mean, we're only at 10 minutes so far. Unless dude does not spawn. Yeah, that's still happening in this game. Where enemies, you run too fast, enemies don't spawn. See, this is the only quest I will say it's probably worth if you mess up to be on New Game Plus One. But I think that, you know, the idea of it, if you mess this quest up that bad, like you don't know, it's not telling you that, you know, you need to be modest. Like, there needs to be something a little bit more the game needs to tell you before you just go out, because you're going to go fight this and be like, ooh, bucket, ooh, bucket, ooh, bucket. Who figured out four? I don't. Who figured four would be the best number and figure that out? I don't know. These devs kind of weird me out, because I would figure that, hey, I'll go collect, you know, I'll go kill all eight bosses and collect them. So the two bosses that we're going to go fight here is going to be basically what I call the fucking twin bitches. That's one. And then we got to go a little bit past that, and we got to go fight the, what's her fucking name? Ugly fucking bitch that fucking laser beams you with a Kamehameha. Abigail? Something like that? Yeah. So we get those two bosses. They'll give you. Now, it's not all the mini bosses. The next mini bosses after this, for in case you don't want to watch video two, to go get in the sense, would be, we need to go Cathleth. We gotta go get the Enchantress out. She's one of them. You can get stuff with. You can get this quest done with. After her, you would probably go to the caves. Go get skin. The skin rest guy down. The skin stealer. That's what I'm calling him. Excuse me. He's two. By that time, if you can make it all the way up that section, you go to the snow area. There is a little area of the top part up there. I forgot what the name of it is, but you go fight the grunge bitch. That would be three. And four, I believe, is going to be the guy that is guarding the bottom part of Sanctuary. Oh, yeah, we need the key. All right. Forgot about that. I'm just doing this right here because this area right here is basically has two of them right next to each other. So it's kind of fast to do this real quick. And what I'll do for the second video is I'm just going to go ahead and just open the area real quick while this video is uploading. So that way it's done. But Bell Bro should come and help us out here in a second. Even though he's absolutely doing no damage. There's like a hair. All right, that's done. Now remember, I recommend not collecting the buckets, because if you collect the bucket, he becomes aggressive towards you. He hates you after that. Unless you want to deal with him. And by all means, that's you. If you want to go ahead and collect four buckets and fight at the same time, go for it. Personally, I'm not going that route. I'm going the route where we're going to grab the buckets after. We'll turn them in, and then we're going to do the next four buckets. So, Hopefully you guys are doing well. I would like to go ahead and take this moment in time right now to go ahead and thank our members that's we've joined on the channel. We got now 20 members that has joined the channel, has become, you know, fellow Lord of Fallen Bros. And we just changed out emotes to on the channel for them. So hopefully you guys will come join us. Do plan this Thursday, if everything goes well, or Wednesday, we're going to be hosting game show night. That's going to be fun. Let me put it this way. If I still got your attention real quick and you haven't skipped the video, or, you know, you're too upset at me for running this game and not opening the area first. What we're going to be doing on the channel starting now, there's going to be a video that's going to be going out once a week. And the video which I'm going to be creating is going to be an event video that's going to tell you the time, the date, and the place of when we're going to do what's called Lords of the Fallen events. And these Lords of the Fallen events, if you see how many, if you take a look at my souls right now, you're going to see, oh boy, he's got a lot of souls, you know. Well, we found a dupe glitch, okay? And not being that person who's like going to be a dick about holding on to it and all that good shit, I decided that I want to give this away to people. I want to give away souls. I want to give away chunks. I want to give away plus 10 boss weapons. I want to give that away to our community. And what better way than to host a game show? And the game shows are going to be all different rule based. So you'll have one that's going to be like, hey, come on in and run around. You got 1 minute to collect all the stuff. And once 1 minute passes, you get kicked out the game. And whatever you got, you got. And the next person comes join in and does the same thing. We're looking at doing also invade style battles. Let her shoot her beam real quick. And with that one, it's a little bit different. That one's going to be a little bit of a different idea. But the idea behind that one is going to be basically like, hey, you come invade and you see how long you can survive against a level 26,000 fucking mob boss, pretty much. She moved. I was not paying attention, you see? I get stupid sometimes. Where's she going at this time? Let me pay attention for a second because I don't want to make this video last that damn long for y'all. Where did she go? Oh, she's over there. Let's not be like Bell Bro and get hit with that shit. Trying to make this fight go a little bit fast. I'm tired of fucking dealing with this shit. Ursula, that's what was her name. It wasn't Abigail. It was fucking Ursula. Where is she? Can you tell why I hate New Game Plus One right now? I'm at full build and I'm dealing with a bullet sponge who this one can heal. This is not challenging. This is stupid in all regards. She's not more aggressive, nothing like that. It's just stupid to me. But again, that is just me. All right, what I recommend here, you see, we got a new item. That's our next bucket. So that is 1, 2, 3. That's 4, isn't it? That's 4. All right. Grab it. We have our first pride of the bucketards. We got to make a run back to the twins. We'll grab that one. Then we got to go to Bale Bro's place. Go grab his. Go back to the very first one. Grab that one. That's 4 buckets. And then we'll get the feet. And then all we got to do is do another 4. And then boom. There you go. This is actually a very long fucking quest. It wouldn't be long if you're a person that's already completed a game or had characters you know has already complete the game. Wouldn't be long at all. And if this is droppable, which I'm not sure right now off the bat if it's this is going to be droppable or not, but if it's droppable, this is going to be something that I will be giving away to people. So you don't have to do this quest. Like, we've been giving away the pumpkin mask, so just join us on our live streams and be a person, and you can grab this stuff yourself too. All right, since I don't want to basically lose these souls just yet, because we got plus 10 boss weapons to basically bring up. We're gonna go ahead. We're gonna warp. Darn. You know, that's what happens when you rush so fast that you forget. You forget to grab the main vestiges. You're just so excited and everything else. So this video is gonna be a little bit longer, but we gotta go grab 2 more. It's fine. So there's 8 mini bosses you have to take care of. You take care of the 8 mini bosses, you can get these rewards. Now, I'm not sure if you can basically, I'm just going to offer this as a thing. If you're a new game plus 1 person right now, I'm not sure if you can go ahead, collect 4, reset the game and do the same 4 all over again, and then go collect it and go collect the other part. I don't think that's what's going to happen. Because look what happens when you go try to get him too, I think. It says, hand it over, nothing happens. You cannot be greedy. The rules in this game so far is do not be greedy. We will put our vestige, our seedling right here, so that way we can come right back. So in this quest, it's all about greed. You want to be in moderation. You collect over 4, apparently you're considered a greedy son of a bitch. Why? Because you're greedy. Everybody's greedy. I think it's a little bit harsh. I'm not going to lie. I think it's a little bit harsh that if you collect 5, that, you know, pretty much it's over. You got to restart the entire game in order to do the quest again, because you can only collect 3 buckets after that. And those 3 buckets will never appear because of this reason. But I'll just say that future wise, I would hope that with this quest, what they would do is make it to where you can discard 1 at a time, because if I go ahead and go to discard, I have to discard all 5. And I would make it to where you discard 1. So that way, okay, you can't collect the second one, but you can still click the first. And I don't know why I didn't jump there, but apparently my character didn't want to jump. Gotta love it. I got full sprint on it. He didn't want to run. the heck? Again? Look, this only happens when I'm recording. Like, I'm trying to rush this for you guys. I don't want you to sit here for a 40-minute video. I made a mistake. I didn't do the vestige. And we're gonna edit this video, apparently. I don't like editing videos. I like giving clear-cut videos. I like it to where I showcase what we're doing. Let's see. Out of curiosity, would it be faster to have to go backwards? Wouldn't I be faster to go backwards? Would that save us some time? This is not backwards. Bear with me. I've never done a backwards run. I'm going to assume that it shouldn't be too difficult of an idea. I've never done this. I've never actually gone backwards. I'm not even sure if you can. I would think you could. I would hope you could. Because this technically would be a faster route. Oh, I'm just so excited to go get this item and show it to you guys, and then do a second video. I don't think we can go backwards. No, we can. We made it. I'm gonna be honest here. I almost didn't think we could make that jump, but we made that jump. Like I said, the next video we're going to do for part two on this, if I do a part two, it's going to be a lot faster, because what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go do the run really quickly on the live stream, and we're going to go populate that one. So, I got you, fam. Just know I got you. Know I got you, your back community. Even though it seems like in some cases the devs aren't really helping us out with stuff, they're giving us stuff, which is nice, but not what we really want. I mean, a quest here is nice. The quest line is nice. Don't get me fucking wrong. The quest line's nice, but I want a fucking working game, bro. Grab this. And that should be 4 buckets. Jump off. Yeah. Should have just to warp to our seedling. Thank God that this is here. Now let's go turn in our reward. And we have now Bucket Lord shoes. Are they droppable? Is my only question. Let's find them. Oops. Yes, we can drop them. So we can dupe this. So if you don't want to go through the hassle of doing all this, I'll get you some bucket shoes. There you go, Bucket Bros. You want to be a Bucket Bro? I got you covered. All right. Until next time, guys, take it easy. Have a good one. Video's going to be 30 minutes long. Do apologize, but it's what happens. Take it easy, and I'll catch you on the flip side.